Good afternoon. My name is Shinyere Onwuchekwa of the World Media Magazine, and I'm here at the 22nd Annual Rainbow Push Wall Street Project Economic Summit. I'm here with the son of the venerable Reverend Jesse Jackson Jr. And your name is Jonathan.
Jonathan Jackson. How are you?
I am good. First of all, I would like to congratulate you for a job well done with this summit that took place. What did it take? What was the involvement to get to this point?
Well, it's constant reaching out. It's access. This year's theme is talking about the 400th year of Africans in the America, 1619 to 2019. It's in 1711, African Americans were still being bought and sold on Wall Street. Hmm. It was in 2015, we honored 300 years of Africans in New York City having been bought and sold in the Wall Street market. It's where its original name comes from. Now we're talking about the new opportunities, the new forecast that we should have on inclusion, our economics, our right to ownership. It's taken a long time for us to get to this point, and we have to continue to foster the inclusion, foster knocking down barriers of discrimination and racism so that we can have opportunities at ownership, not just employment.
Okay, so so wonderful. What exactly, I will ask you, if somebody wants to take advantage of this, what would they come up from this? What specifically would you advise them?
Well, you've had senior vice presidents of major corporations. You've had the chief legal counsel of CVS, Aetna, now one of the largest corporations in America, saying they're looking for real estate developers. They're looking for persons that have products and services so they can do distribution for them. Those persons that want to do insurance, they're open for business. So they look to come to meet the entrepreneurs that have some services to provide. So they could come here to secure contracts. Persons have gotten $1 billion underwritings in finance. Persons have gotten the opportunity to do telecommunications, coming out of here on the spot with the CEOs from AT&T to build towers. And there's so many other opportunities that have come about.
Okay. To the common man on the street who doesn't know anything about this, how can they go about acquiring these opportunities?
Go to the website. That's where our general information is. Come out. Get involved. This isn't something that you can stay at home and Facebook and Snapchat and Twitter and Instagram. You've got to come out and meet the people. People still do business with people they know, they trust, and that they have a relationship, and people that they have to do business with. So if you're at home emailing and saying nobody emailed me back because the CEO might have been out, and they're going to have to look someone in the eye before they do something. So there's still a marketplace of people meeting people knowing people, and we have to come out and get involved.
Okay. Your father has always been on the front lines. Sometimes he goes on missions in very dangerous areas. Was there ever any time when you were afraid or discouraged and you felt like it's not worth it, you know, his life being in danger?
You know, no, we've always had a faith and a belief and felt secure. All he's had is the Bible. Doesn't have the power of state, doesn't have that portfolio. Reverend Martin Luther King only had a Bible. He didn't have security guards or a private plane. So this is a faith-driven mission. And I've gone with him to Iraq to meet with Saddam Hussein, to Syria to meet with Bashar Assad and Hafez Assad. I've gone with him to meet with Muammar Gaddafi and Castro and others, and never had any fear.
Thank you. So what will be your message to the next generation to continue with what your father started?
Yeah, I would say that that this is a marathon, and this is a relay. And so one generation runs the baton, another generation comes along. I don't particularly, and I know it's semantical, talk about a new generation. They come from somewhere. It's the continuation of the history. And so it's unbroken. So I would say, find out as much as you can from the previous generation, incorporate it, adapt it, and move it forward into the current generation. Music is still the same, the rhythm changes. You know, it's the space in between the notes that makes the music. So it's another generation's turn to be on the front line. It's not about replacing a generation, but you should take full advantage of those persons that have a wealth of experience, that have been here longer than you, that have done more, and then advance that.
Thank you. Thank you so much.